a recap of how we configure everything in Fabric 2. I was talking with Fabric 1, so now into Fabric 2. Again, the spine, we already covered that before. Then for the routing, then the underlay routing that you may have here on that specific spine, which is used as well as a underlay. I've got a connectivity to Fabric 4 here, for instance, and I will use an IPv4 peering, BGP peering, in order to learn the routes for the loopback. Okay, so this is here done on the spine as well. So you have that config extracted here for that specific one. And then I move on with the spine 4, exactly the same config concept. Right. And then we go to the leaf for Fabric 2. So this is a summary. Okay, so again, I will cover the leaf that is there, regular leaf, and then I will cover the border. Server connectivity, nothing new here. Define VLAN and attachment, layer physics to the spine, the loopback address. Then you define your VRF, so we can just have a short review of that. So the again, the local route target and the global route target. So VRF1 is exported to all over Fabric. So important to have the route target defined as the global one. Same for VRF2. Here you see VRF4, for instance, I don't export it. So I'm not defining any route target global here. Here, for the demonstration purpose, the VLAN 10 here is extended. However, you see that the VLAN 21 is locally extended to the Fabric, but there, I've got no extension of that VLAN 21 outside. So I don't define a local, a global scope route target for VLAN 21. And what I said here is that for instance, VLAN 40, which is about VLAN part of VRF4, I'm using a route target auto here, just because you may see that at some customer, this is purely for internal Fabric, okay? And don't play with that when you have an external BGP session. SVI, so again, I've got my SVI IP identical to the active gateway. I'm using an IP helper with inside the VRF default. I will source the DHCP relay from the loopback zero here. It's a VSF stack, so there is no a single control plane, so it's not like a VSX primary and secondary. So loopback zero is enough. And it's I'm defining for troubleshooting loopback 12 here inside VRF1. For the VXLAN interface, you have the one-to-one mapping again for the locally defined VLANs here, VLAN 10 that I've got here, VLAN 21 that I've got here. For the routing, nothing different than what we already covered, so I'm going to go fast here. And then the border. So that's the summary of the border here compared to what we have here. So in the demonstration, I've got a standalone unit, okay, versus what you would obviously have in operation and what I had in the Fabric 1. I had a VSX pair, but in operation, you always have VSX pair. No server and no host connected directly here. That's on purpose for you to understand the consequence of that. And typically, even if there is no local VLAN, we will have to define local VLAN in order to make sure that VLAN are extended. No SVI configure as well here. Again, this is done on purpose because you may you will understand better how it works. And I've got those loopback defined as well inside VRF1 and inside VRF2. Let's move on with the consideration for extension of VLAN. So VLAN 10 here and VLAN 12 are extended between Fabric. They must be configured on the border VTEP, regardless there is host or not behind. So this is very important, and this is a source of mistake. Those VLANs must be configured here. Right, so you must make sure that you have a show VLAN on that one, and any VLAN that is subject to be extended to other Fabric must be set. Okay, so here it's a recap of what I mentioned. There is a typo here. Add extended VLAN in the border. So here, typically, those VLAN 10 and 12 are not defined locally. Please add them. Okay, and inside EVPN, you need to add VLAN 10 as well, and to put at least the global scope route target for them. You do not necessarily need to have the local route target, because actually you do not have local host connected here. So the global route target is enough. And here, typically, I redistribute the host for that VLAN 10, and I do not redistribute the host for VLAN 12. This is for demonstration purpose. Most of the time, you will redistribute always the host, but here I do that just to make sure that we have a variation in the configuration so that you can see what it can lead to in terms of outcome and show command. The interface for VXLAN, again, for VLAN that are extended, we must set those extra VLANs, even if they are not local, into the interface VXLAN. So please remember there is three things to do. Set up the VLAN on the switch, do the L2 VNI VLAN mapping in the EVPN, and do the config in the VXLAN interface. So three things to remember. Good. So then we have the routing in place. Okay, so here, nothing different to what I already explained on the VTEP that was the border VTEP that was in Fabric 1. Just a recap here.